When you first open Blender, you will open in the layout workspace, and the 3D editor window will have a light source, a camera, and a cube. What you see in the 3D editor workspace is known as the scene. Upon first opening Blender, you will also be in the 3D Editor Workspace's object mode. By selecting the mode icon, you can see that the 3D Editor window has six modes: object mode, edit mode, sculpt mode, vertex paint mode, weight paint mode, and texture paint mode. For modeling Trainz assets, we are going to use only two of these modes, object mode and edit mode. Object mode is used to add and manipulate three-dimensional objects, also known as meshes. The cube is one of 10 predefined meshes that you can add to your scene. They are a cone, an icosphere, a torus, a cube, a cylinder, a sphere, a plane, a monkey head, affectionately known as Suzanne, and a circle. These predefined meshes are called primitives. A list can be found in the Add menu under the Mesh submenu. A mesh is always added at the location of the 3D cursor, a red and white circle. The 3D cursor is initially at the center of the default scene, that is, at X equals 0, Y equals 0, and Z equals 0. This is also known as the origin. But the 3D cursor can be placed anywhere using the keyboard shortcut Shift plus right mouse button. The 3D cursor can be placed back at the origin using the keyboard shortcut Shift plus the C key. The primitive meshes are used to start modeling. One usually starts with either the cube, the cylinder, or the sphere, depending upon the overall shape of the model or the component of the model that you are starting to model first. The 3D editor window is where you create your model. The model can be made up of more than one mesh, each mesh being a separate part that is listed in the outline window. Since we are going to export our models to Trainz, where they will be placed in a scene, we will be creating just one model at a time. Your scene in the 3D editor window can be viewed from different angles, and there are several ways to select your viewing angle. The View menu, the colorful widget in the upper right-hand corner of the 3D editor window, or the number pad keys. I like to use the number pad keys. Number pad 1 key is front view. Number pad 3 key is right side view. And number pad 7 key is top view. Control plus number pad 1 key is back view. Control plus number pad 3 key is left side view. Control plus number pad 7 key is bottom view. The number pad 5 key toggles between orthogonal view and perspective view. In perspective view, meshes in the distance appear smaller, as they would in the real world. In orthogonal view, the meshes appear the same size, even if in the distance. As you will see, this makes modeling easier, and this is the view you will use most of the time for modeling. So far, we have been viewing the cube in solid view mode, but there are other ways we can view a mesh. In wireframe mode, you see the edges. You can toggle between solid mode and wireframe mode with the keyboard shortcut Shift plus the Z key. In X-ray mode, you can see through the model, thus seeing all of the edges. Material view mode is used to view your model with a fixed lighting setup determined by an HDRI. A 360-degree image that wraps around your model. There are 8 built-in HDRIs you can choose from, and more you can add from the internet. Render view is used to view your model with the lighting you have set up for your scene. You can apply more than one light to your scene, and there are 4 different types you can choose from. An easy way to switch between view modes is the keyboard shortcut, the Z key, which brings up a pie menu with 4 options: wireframe, solid, material preview, and rendered. To navigate your scene, you can rotate, pan, or zoom. To rotate the scene, hold down the middle mouse button and drag the mouse. To pan the scene, hold down the shift key and the middle mouse button and drag the mouse. To zoom your scene, scroll with the middle mouse button. You can also use the gizmos in the upper right-hand corner of the 3D editor window. To rotate the scene, hover the mouse cursor over the colorful icons until a gray sphere appears. Then use the left mouse button and drag. To pan the scene, hover the mouse cursor over the hand icon. Then use the left mouse button and drag. To zoom the scene, hover the mouse cursor over the magnifying glass icon, then left mouse button and drag. Individual meshes can be moved, rotated, or scaled. Each of these changes is known as a transformation. To move a mesh, select the mesh with the left mouse button and use the keyboard shortcut, the G key, G for grab, and drag. Left mouse button to complete the transformation. Use the keyboard shortcut, the Command key plus the Z key, to delete the last action. The movement may be confined to the X, Y, or Z axis by specifying the axis, and a specified distance can also be entered. For example, selecting the cube, then the keyboard shortcuts the G key and the Y key, and typing in 5 will restrict the movement to 5 units on the y-axis. Left mouse button to complete the transformation. Use the keyboard shortcut, the Command key plus the Z key, to delete the last action. To rotate, select the mesh and use the keyboard shortcut, the R key, R for rotate, and drag. Left mouse button to complete the transformation. Use the keyboard shortcut, the Command key plus the Z key, to delete the last action. You can specify the direction of rotation and the number of degrees. For example, selecting the cube, then the keyboard shortcuts, the R key and the Z key, and then typing in 45, will restrict the rotation to 45 degrees on the Z axis. Left mouse button to complete the transformation. Use the keyboard shortcut, the Command key plus the Z key, to delete the last action. To scale a mesh, select the mesh, then the keyboard shortcut, the S key, S for scale, and drag. Restrictions can also be applied. To select individual meshes, left mouse button select the mesh in the 3D editor window. The mesh will be highlighted in yellow. You can also select a mesh in the outline window. To select more than one mesh, hold down the Shift key as you make your selections. The last mesh selected will be outlined in yellow and is known as the active mesh. The other meshes will be outlined in orange. To deselect, left mouse button select anywhere in the 3D editor window other than on a mesh. To select all of the meshes, you can use the keyboard shortcut, the A key. Using the A key twice deselects all the meshes. To undo an action, simply select the keyboard shortcut Ctrl plus the Z key. You can undo several sequential actions by select Ctrl plus the Z key more than once. To reverse the process and redo an action, simply select Shift plus Ctrl plus the Z key. By default, the number of undos and redos is set to 32, but you can set this value to anything you like in the Preferences window under the Systems tab. I prefer to increase it to 100. Be sure to save your changes in the Preferences window before closing the window.